fence, there might be an elephant busy eating that tree that grows right by Shawa is a buffalo thorn or a Ziziphus, and the elephants often eat that over the fence. Yeah. So yeah.
Well, every time I shower, I look because I'm still hoping.
Yeah.
To get that.
No, you will. Shower long enough, stay long enough, you will see them.
Yeah.
I think we'll have many more fire chats. I've got no doubts about that.
Yeah. So look forward to it.
Cool. We're going to get Rexon around just now. Okay. Unless Katja, do you want to say hello quickly? Katja just joined as well. She's been away for a couple of days. And nice to chat around the fire.
Rexon.
Always. Rex.
Yeah, but how are you?
I'm good, man. I'm going to sit down here again because...
Me too. I'd like to sit down. This is more natural. I remember when I was young, when you get the elders sitting around the fire, what you're supposed to do, you have to go on the ground.
Yeah.
Not to go on the post. That shows the respect that you have to be ground. The elders must be on top of a chair or post, whatever it could be around in that area. So it really gives me, it reminds me in early days when I was boy in the area.
Yeah, no, that's actually earlier this afternoon, we were looking around the fire, I was chatting to Rex and saying, what do you think, should we sit like this maybe? And Rex was like, yeah, nice change, but also something nice about being low down to the fire. Huh?
It's beautiful. I really like this.
Rex, well, we're going to chat just now, just quickly, like I said, Katja just walked by as well, just to say hello. And also, Rex, I spoke to Charles earlier today, we're going to see if he could join us tonight, but he's got some family things he's got to go home for.
Yeah.
And we're going to try and do that. Maybe next Sunday. Again, it just depends on Charles's leave. He's either leaving on the Sunday or the Saturday. Get Charles around us. I know there's been quite a few questions regarding the Kahumas and just sort of general wildlife. Not general wildlife. Wildlife we're aware of, but further out than where we can drive. So we're going to get Charles in here at some stage and start getting some other characters. Yeah. And Katja. That was actually my other point. But maybe not tonight. Somewhere in the next couple of weeks.
Yeah. It's really amazing. If you look at the old... You know, we're driving like 1,000 hectares. Something's happening far. Like today, early in the morning, they located Kuhuma Pride, far southeast of Bushloch, some macaw called Cheetah
Pan. It's far for them to move as well, eh?
Yeah, very far. And I had, late this afternoon, our friend Graham Cook, he was reported, a lion kill, looked like some Kayamanzi area.
Mm.
Looked like a 2 mile, they were trying to track them early in the morning, the Manyaniti boys.
Mm.
Look, they might be on the kill somewhere. We haven't heard about Josimel where probably might be moving in and where, but
yeah.
We heard that on the Kuhumas there's 5 female and 7 youngsters. I was very, very curious today to ask how many cubs are still there, how many females, which is really amazing. Look like the youngsters, they've grown up.
Yeah, I haven't seen them for... Have you seen them anywhere, Rex?
No, I haven't seen them. I just ask guys and ask Andrew to send me pictures on Facebook and so on.
Yeah.
If I can see the picture, how big is the cubs. But if they're still around, maybe one day we might be lucky if we patient enough for the guys, ask them. We want to see these lions. They might take us.
Yeah.
The sighting, I believe.
Yeah. At the same time, also, if they're going as far down as Bush Lodge, guys, it's maybe difficult to understand if you don't understand the map of it, but... the Kuhuma Pride, which is a pride of lions, to give you a quick background for the newer people with us, that used to be around here quite often. Then December last year, the Mapocho males came, they killed some of the youngsters. And then again in, was it March, Rex, in my days?
Somewhere
March 14, 16, rings a bell, I could be wrong. They killed a lioness and some youngsters. And then the Kuhuma Pride have been far up north, Buffalsuk area, Torchwood sometimes. And now they're coming further, sort of south and east, like Rex said. So they're moving. So hopefully at some stage, maybe... The Pochos haven't been here for so long. When last did we see the Mapochos? Months.
Yes, months.
So maybe they'll come back down here as well.
It's like what I was saying to them, I was mentioning this Mapocho, they just come here and push all the animals. They're no longer coming back. I hope because the Kuhuma Pride, the tracks of them, they were somewhere Central Road, Second Rock, inside Torchwood, heading sort of south. Slowly, maybe they will take some couple of months to come. Maybe by December, they might be around in the area again.
Yeah.
More especially the cubs are grown up. It will be a very good chance for Kuhumas to come here because the cubs they can able to defend itself, run away if there's anything approach them. But by that time, the female might be ready. The male might be interested in mating with the youngster. Especially the females. The young males automatically they will move to somewhere.
Yeah, they need
maybe
to move anyway.
Stage, they will come back. You never know.
Yeah.
Yes, yeah. It's really amazing. It's all about sighting, and we were having beautiful sighting, I mean, in the course of the week. And I heard you have Sasek, we have, I mean, last Sunday I was not around. I mean, it's got a lot of things happening around here, leopards coming in and out. But in the last 2 days, it looked like it's a little bit difficult to find these animals. I don't know what's going on.
They're waiting for the rain, hopefully.
Maybe.
The rain is something that hopefully will find us soon. Water is getting dry. But yeah, we've been very lucky. We had both the youngsters, Tingana and Saseka. We had Karula, who didn't look like she's pregnant yet. Yes, she was thin that night. She was looking very, very tiny. So.
And we were having questions like, she's pregnant or not?
Yeah. What do you think, Rex? If you think back to that night, would you say she's pregnant or maybe she needs to find another Madoda again?
It looked like the way Peter, she was calling around, automatically a leopard won't call, I mean, for just... And scent marking, we've seen a scent marking. It might happen looking for a male, a second mate. We'll never know what's going on there until maybe if we push it like a month or month and a half, we'll be able to tell exactly what she might be pregnant or not. Because you never know, a leopard can mate, and as a result, we'll know that she's pregnant. Meanwhile, she won't be on that stage, and she might be checking a perfect male that will be the right male to mate and protect the youngster in the area.
Sure. But that time when she was around camp here, when she was at the washing line and we heard her for... That's already 3 months ago, isn't it?
Yes.
So from that time, I think nothing happened. Yeah. She got a bit of attention, but nothing more.
It can happen if... Look at the the information. I remember reading the book called Beat About the Bush. A leopard and a lion can come into pester ostrich. If two males compete, she can mate with the male for just, to attract the male that she's here for her, for him. And if she's not happy, she might, go to the second male that look like more, he's more healthy and strong. He can able to protect the youngster. That can happen. It's the same, you'll never know.
Yeah, that's one thing you can say. There's always a surprise.
Yes, really.
Man. Rex, we missed you around the fire other night, sir. I'm very happy for you that you stayed home more often now, but it's nice to sit by the fire.
It's beautiful.
Look. What was that?
It looked like it's an audio.
It sounded like a lion.
Lion or buffalo, having interaction somewhere. It will be very nothing. It can be very loud, and you're able to hear that on the sound itself. It looks like a buffalo, maybe it's or lion is going for buffalo, and they're having that interaction. So it's really amazing. Planning to talk about the sighting of the week. We have seen a lot of animal, of course. Although I haven't seen leopard. Leopard is my best animal like I like to see.
I missed the leopard.
I missed the leopard, but we have a wonderful sighting today. Look at those buffalo, and look at the females with different horns. Very, very beautiful. Sometimes, you just drive very close to the buffalo, start looking how the horns look like and how this female look like. Yeah. You just surprised me, man. The buffalo with the brown light eye. I even noticed something like that when I got the buffalo. I look a buffalo, they're all the same. But really today I checked something, all the buffalo are slightly all different, even color. If you take a look, eye and something.